Now let us study the experiment of measurement of internal resistance of a cell by using a potentiometer. Here you can see the experimental setup in which just for simplicity we have taken the potentiometer wire to be a straight wire, and in primary circuit the battery, rheostat and an emitter is connected, and in the secondary circuit we are having a battery which is connected with a galvanometer and a jockey. Now, in this situation, if we just find out the balancing length for the battery, here we can see if the balancing length is found to be L1 as we can see in the experiment. Here we can see when EMF is balanced, here we can see its EMF E can be written as lambda L1, which is here equation 1. Now, externally, an external resistance R is also connected with the battery. So, in this situation, obviously the battery, which is always there in series with its internal resistance, a current is supplied by the battery, and obviously the potential difference across the battery will be reduced. So, L1 will no longer be the balancing length. And if the potential difference is reduced, we need to balance it again by reducing the balancing length. And here we can say at a length L2, the new balancing length is obtained. Then we can say when external resistance R is connected, then the potential difference across the terminals of battery we can simply write as IR, which is equals to lambda L2. And the current I here you can see it is flowing only in the circuit of battery and external resistance, because in the situation of null deflection no current is there in the galvanometer. So here the value of current is E by R plus capital R. So if we substitute the value, this will be ER by R plus capital R is lambda L2. This can be taken as equation 2. Now in this situation, if we divide the two equations, here if we write 1 by 2, if these two equations are divided, this will result as R plus R by capital R is equals to L1 by L2. And if we further simplify this expression, here you can see the value of internal resistance of battery will be R L1 minus L2 upon L2. This is the expression we are getting. And here L1, L2 we already obtained, and the value of R we can easily get because here the external resistance can be placed by putting a resistance box instead of capital R. So for various values of capital R we can find out the value of small r, and all the results can be averaged out to get a relatively accurate result of the internal resistance of this battery.